Dear students, this is in continuation to my previous lecture on Introduction to Entomology Part 1. This is again the Introduction to Entomology Part 2. Now in my previous Part 1 lecture, I was just trying to tell you all about a typical insect. How are they successful? What are the reasons for their success? And today I would just in short tell you all the structure and the uses, the importance of the insects in the ecosystem. Now if you, I told you the word insect comes when you say insecta, this is featured by the body divided into three parts, that is head, thorax and abdomen. So here the head, this I've tried to show you a typical structure in a grasshopper, which you very commonly see in your houses, in the garden of your houses, and you can see them. Now this is a typical insect. So the structure comprises of, or the morphological structure comprises of, the head, which is the anterior part of the insect body, with eyes, antennae and mouth parts. This is followed by thorax, the body section after the head, with the legs and wings. Now the legs and wings are borne by this segment, this part of the insect, which is the thorax. Now the thorax itself is further divided into three parts, that is prothorax, the mesothorax and the metathorax. The abdomen, the posterior section of the body containing the reproductive and digestive organs, is the abdominal part. Now certain other structures which one can observe morphologically are the presence of spiracles, which are actually the opening of the respiratory system. The respiratory system in insect comprises of the tracheal system. Now this tracheal system, because all these things would be discussed in details in the paper first of the entomology part. I'm just trying to give you all a brief introduction about certain things which you would need to know about an insect. So spiracles actually are the opening of the tracheal system outside the body, from where the exchange of gases takes place. Then the legs. Now each leg, now because there are three pairs of legs in most, generally if you observe, the legs comprise of the major parts, which is the coxa. The coxa is the section of the leg that is attached to the body. This is followed by trochanter, which is the second segment of a leg between the coxa and the third segment, which is known as the femur. The femur is the third segment of a leg between the trochanter and the tibia. Now in this figure, you can see that the first two legs are smaller in size, whereas the third one is quite enlarged. And this enlarged actually is because of the very strong femora, the femur part. Why it is so, we will discuss it later on, but right now just to see that the leg is divided into major segments, that is coxa, trochanter and femur, and the last one is the tibia. Coxa actually is just the part where it joins. Tibia actually is the fourth segment of a leg between the femur and the tarsus. Now the leg segment after the tibia are subdivided into several sections, which are known as the tarsal segments or the tarsi. These terminate into what are the claws. The genitalia are the sexual organs, which are present on the apical part of the abdomen, the last segment of the abdomen. And of course the wings, which are the outgrowths of the body wall. These are the outgrowths of the body wall, which enable the insects to fly. The first pair of wings is sometimes modified into a protective covering for the hind wing. It is modified in certain insects like beetle, Coleoptera, but then we would be taking up in details about this. But this is a typical structure of an insect if you just see it morphologically. Moving on to the importance or significance of insects, they are useful in pollination, decomposition of organic material, soil enrichment and aeration, being consumed as food, controlling other insect pests as biological control agents in the form of predators and parasites, as in research as experimental material, as bioindicators, and in warfare as biological weapons. Now see here, these are certain insects which are the honeybees and the butterflies, which are used as which are very helpful in pollination. Now, pollination is a process in which the nectar or the pollen from the pollen from the male plant is transferred to the stigma of the female plant, which helps in the process of fertilization. And that is the reason that we, from the flower, the fruits and seeds develop. So this phenomena is known as pollination. And insects are important pollinators because they carry the pollen from one plant to another and thus pollinating them. This is an insect, the carrion beetle, which is a decomposer. And decomposition in nature is very important. If there is no decomposition, then all the dead and dead organisms would ruin this globe. So decomposition is very, very significant as far as, because every organism has got a lifespan, and after that life, it ends or it dies off. And if after dying, if the body or the body parts are not decomposed, there would be foul smell and lot of infection all around the globe. These are dung beetles, again, same decomposers. Now, these are mealyworms, which have been served in a bowl as a food. And these constitute an important food in certain parts of the globe, especially Japan, China. They are consumed as food. Now, this is an example, rather a classical example of biological control. As the name indicates, biological control means, biology means living. So, use of living for the control. Now, here this is a very classical example. Here, the insect is controlling an insect. The insect which you see in the red and black spots is actually the ladybird beetle, Vidalia beetle. And it is eating the white material, which actually is the scale insect, the cottony cushion scale. So the insect controlling the insect, eating the insect and thus controlling. This is a classical example of biological control. There are many various examples, but this is one such example. You all know, you have studied it, must have definitely studied in school sometime or the other, because the zoology has been one of your subjects. And if zoology is one of your subjects, or even in biology, you must have definitely heard about this insect, which is Drosophila. Most of the genetic experiments, the experiments in cell biology and genetics, have been carried out on this insect. So the insects are a very important part of research, or they make the main constitution of research, because research or the experimental organism. As bioindicators, as the word says, indicator, that means definitely it is going to indicate something, some quality. Bio is something related to the biological aspect. So bioindicators actually are those which are used or employed, or which can be employed for identifying the certain environment. Here, this is an example of dragonfly. Now, dragonfly is an insect whose young ones, which are known as naiads, are in the water, because dragonfly lays the eggs in water. The young one, which is termed as the naiad, actually it's a nymph, but because it is an aquatic nymph, it is termed as a naiad. This naiad is in water, whereas the adult insect, which emerges later on, is aerial or is terrestrial in a way. So from the aquatic to the landform. Now, because the young ones are in water, from the egg the naiads come out, and the presence or the egg laying and the development of naiad is very characteristic, and it is not found in all the water. That means the eggs by the dragonflies are not laid in all kinds of water, but it needs a very specific quality of water. So the presence or absence, this is one example. So the presence and absence of a particular insect or a particular insect stage in water is useful in identifying, or can be employed for identifying, the quality of water. Like, well, another example, a dipteran larvae, which is a chironomid larvae. Its presence shows that the water is, the quality is not good. It is dirty water. So just by the presence, they can be employed, and we can just adjudge what is the quality of water. the Colorado beetle. Here, this is a Colorado beetle which has been used as an entomological weapon in World War II. Actually, this insect is a pest insect. It causes harm. It eats up and destroys mainly the potato. So, in the World War II, because the staple food of Europeans mainly comprises of potato, the potato crop was completely damaged, and thus the reason of starvation, and can be called as an entomological weapon. Thank you. So, these are certain important part of the insect as a its role in the ecosystem.